Good afternoon. I've been using a broom on my pores. The snow is so dry. I'm Tally.
Abigail.
I hope I'm not intruding.
No.
I needed to get away for the day. Yeah, our farm is a slaughterhouse right now. My husband is killing his hawks.
Would you like to come in?
Yes, I love that. Or we could just stay out on the porch shivering. I know it's the dullest of all things to have an ignorant neighbor combined spoil a Sunday afternoon.
Oh, no, you're most welcome here. But I know the feeling. Sometimes I imagine during Widow Weldon's visits that I've been plunged up to my eyes in a vat of the prosaic.
Poor Widow Weldon. She got going on a council levy once when I was...
She saw I had noticed her hair and admitted she had been vain about it as a girl. She said that back then she'd worn it longer and plaited in a bun at the back of her head. In the winter sun through the window, her skin had an underflush of rose and violet which so disconcerted me that I had to look away. As always, when it came to speaking and attempting to engage in others' affections, circumstances doomed me to striving and anxiety. From my earliest youth, I was like a pot-bound root, all curled in upon itself.
I hope I'm not keeping you from something.
No. I'm glad you've come.
Finney saw your husband at the cooperage. He mentioned his new method for farrowing his piglets.
With some asperity?
My husband mentions everything with some asperity. I told him that once, and he observed in response that it seemed to be quite a favor to get a kind word from me, and I told him that if he was married to himself, he'd soon find out what a favor it was. My mother always said that having children would resolve that dilemma.
My mother made the same claim.
And yet, here we are, both childless.
My daughter Nellie would have been 5 today.
How does she pass?
Diphtheria, last September.
God, I'm so sorry.